Hi, my name is Mike Tholfsen, and I'm a product manager on the Microsoft Education team. And today I'm going to be talking about Microsoft Teams and accessibility. I do a lot in my day job about inclusive classrooms and accessibility and making sure all students have access. So I'm excited to talk about all the capabilities in Teams. Also, I'm very active on Twitter, and you can follow the latest updates there. I've got my Twitter handle, and also I have a YouTube channel where I post a lot of how-to videos, especially around inclusive technology. So let's get going. Now, to start off, obviously the word unprecedented is used quite a lot, unprecedented times for educators, for students, for parents, all the challenges with remote learning and hybrid learning and everything in between. Now, Microsoft really has a set of capabilities we are trying to help all sorts of school systems with. Online learning infrastructure is obviously important. Communication tools, which we'll talk a lot about today with Teams. Inclusive access, which is just as important in making sure every student can come along as we're doing remote and hybrid learning. And then professional development, user readiness, training, all those important aspects to make sure everyone can learn and know about our tools. Now, Microsoft Teams, if you're not familiar with it, Teams is the digital hub and it's our education hub that brings together everything in one place. Content, assignments, apps, class notebooks, meetings, and you can do all sorts of great things with personalizing assignments. You can have PLCs, you can have staff communication. We won't cover all those today, but there's lots of great other talks happening at ISTE that go deeper into Teams. We'll be talking about the inclusive side. Now, when it comes to remote learning, this becomes very important for accessibility. So with Teams, you can schedule online meetings with your classes and office hours, creating announcements, assignments, chatting. And it's a good reminder to know that Teams is completely free for educators and students. And there's a lot more at the link on this deck if you're interested in learning more about the free Teams platform and how your school might use it. Now, at a high level, we talk about inclusion and accessibility. That is part of Microsoft's core mission. Our mission in education is to empower every student on the planet to achieve more. That doesn't mean 84% of the students. That doesn't mean 95.3% of the students. It means 100% of students. And all these capabilities you're going to see today are built-in, mainstream, non-stigmatizing, and free. Now, as a high level, just so you understand the entire accessibility platform from Microsoft, these are the six categories our company talks about: learning, visual, hearing, mobility, neurodiversity, and mental health. I'll talk today a bit about, we have learning, dyslexia, hearing, deaf and hard of hearing, vision, some ADHD. But if you want to get all of the details about all the capabilities across the Microsoft 365 platform, and there are many of them, and most people aren't aware of many of them, this link right here, this accessibility sway, is a great link to go through. Maybe after ISTE, when you're sitting back and looking through all the materials, that is a great sway to go through and see the broad swath of things. In the inclusive classroom, when I refer to that, that really breaks down categories into reading, writing, math, and communication. And I'll be talking a bit about communication today with Teams, as well as a little bit on reading with the Immersive Reader. Now, accessibility in Teams, just for people that aren't aware, there's actually quite a few things in Teams and the M365 platform that come in there. We have everything from Immersive Reader, inline translation, live captions, focus mode, together mode, accessibility checker. With OneNote built into Teams, you can use all the inclusive math features and transcripts. And I'll be showing a lot of these new capabilities as we move into this right now. So I'm just going to walk through some of the current and coming soon capabilities. First off is together mode. Now, some people say, oh, together mode is gimmicky. It turns out there's actually a bit of brain science research behind together mode. Now, think about students with attention issues and ADHD, maybe visual impairments, could be cerebral palsy, various reasons why seeing all those 49 squares and changing and people moving around the screen like that can be really discombobulating and it can be confusing. And according to science and brain research, it's overloading on the brain, it overwhelms. Together mode shows that you have the same person in the same spot, you can focus in the same area, and we remove all the backgrounds and distractions. So there's actually a bit of brain science that shows together mode is easier on the brain, and that can be especially helpful for certain students in your class that might have challenges with focus and learning and attention issues. So that's a good one to try out. Spotlight is something that recently rolled out. This allows the educator to pin either themselves or pin a student in the class in a certain Spotlight video. So I'm going to play this video so you can see what it looks like. Now I'm here in a Teams meeting, and I'm going to go pick a certain student named Chelsea, and I'm going to spotlight her for the class. So I zoom in here, I'll choose the dot, 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 and choose Spotlight. And you can see Chelsea is now pinned as a video in the class. And if I want to unpin her, I can do that. And if I want to zoom in and see exactly where that is, you can see the little spotlight icon. And I can click the stop spotlighting up at the top. So I go click stop spotlighting, and I can put that back. And as an educator, I could put the spotlight on myself as well. So Spotlight is really nice for putting attention on different people. We're going to be expanding that feature into dynamic views, which I'll talk about in just a little bit. Another one is focus mode and full screen mode. These recently rolled out. Thinking about students with attention and learning and attention deficit disorder, maybe I want to get rid of all those videos along the bottom. If I choose focus right here, all those videos on the bottom will disappear. In addition, I can go into full screen mode and make the taskbar right here and across the top disappear as well. So both full screen and focus mode have fully rolled out into Teams meetings very recently. So I suggest trying that out with your students. This next feature just is rolling out right now, right during ISTE. We're rolling out our next generation live captions. So captions is where we put the captioning right along the bottom as someone is talking. We've rolled out some new capabilities that include speaker attribution. That means show in the captions exactly who is talking and when. And then also a transcript for the entire meeting and the ability to download that transcript afterwards. So I'm going to hit play on this video. You're going to see I'll share some content, and then I'm going to go to the dot, dot, dot menu and turn on live captions. And you'll see the captions showing right there with my name next to them. And as other people talk, it'll show them. Now I can also start recording and transcribing the meeting as you see here. So now a transcript started. Now if you go down to the captions, you're going to see as other people start talking, like Gabby here, you're going to see her name show up, and Abby. So we have speaker attribution. If I want to stop recording this meeting, I can go back to the dot, dot, dot menu and then end it, and the transcript will get saved automatically. So stop the recording and save the transcript. I can also go back, and if I want to watch transcripts as the meeting is happening, you'll see right here the entire transcript can be seen on the right-hand side. And when I'm done with this meeting, there's a transcript that was saved. So the meeting is ended and you see a transcript. I can download it as a VTT or a document, and this transcript is pinned into the meeting automatically. So all the transcript with the speaker attribution right here, all of that is automatically put right into the meeting follow-up. And you can also download it for later as well. Those are a bunch of great capabilities. Can help with deaf and hard of hearing students, but also students that might just want to see the transcript afterwards or be able to follow along or share that outwards as an educator if someone else needs that transcript. All of these capabilities are coming into Teams meetings at the end of November, so right about now. The other thing I'll mention is breakout rooms. While that is not necessarily an inclusive and accessible feature specifically, breakout rooms has fully rolled out now in Teams. The best part about that from the accessibility standpoint is every single feature in Teams meetings also works in breakout rooms. So if you put breakout rooms with your students, they can use together mode, they can do live transcriptions and download, they can do all of the captioning, they can do focus mode. All of those features apply in the breakout room meetings as well. So everything you see here also works in breakout rooms. Now coming soon, this is a great one, dynamic views. This is probably one of my favorite features that's coming by the end of 2020. You can see an overlay of a student in this case, kind of like a weatherman or weatherwoman and a green screen. But think about deaf and hard of hearing and sign language interpreters. You'll be able to pin back on this is just a GIF that's rotating, you'll be able to pin different people on that right-hand side. So maybe you have the sign language interpreter up there, maybe you put the sign language interpreter over the screen, you'll be able to customize different types of views in your Teams meetings. So it's fantastic for the ability to have sign language or different students appear in different parts overlaying, and these dynamic views will also make, I think, accessibility really powerful in these meeting scenarios. Next up, we're going to go to the Immersive Reader. Now, the Immersive Reader, if you've never seen it or heard of it, it is an inclusively designed tool where we took the latest science and research around reading and focused inclusively on dyslexia. And we said, what if we use these techniques to help all people with reading? And this Immersive Reader is now, it's in Word, it's in OneNote, and it's in Teams. And it's in conversations and chats. I'll just play this video with the voiceover so you can see how the Immersive Reader works.
I'm on any message in the posts right here, and I go to the dot, dot, dot menu, and I choose Immersive Reader right here. It launches the full Immersive Reader, so I can start reading out loud.
Ocean's discussion today.
I can change the voice speed, faster, slower, male or female voices. I can do all the same parts of Immersive Reader. So I can change the background color. I can increase spacing. Maybe I want it blue here. Maybe I'll put on line focus. I can even translate. So if I want to translate right here, I'm going to scroll down and change this into Spanish. And now maybe I'll just change the entire document to Spanish. Choose read aloud.
Me gustaría que estuviera seguro y leyera las páginas.
And if I want to go back to the original, I click on top. This is also enabled in chat. So if I go to the chat up here in the upper left, here's a message that I have, and I can just hover in the same way and click the dot, 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 and drop it down and choose Immersive Reader in the chat. And I can get the exact same type of message play.
So all of that is built right into conversations and chat in Teams. In addition, it's also built into Immersive Reader in assignments. So assignments, maybe your students have a large description or instructions in the assignments. Immersive Reader is built right into assignments. So let's see how that works.
So first off, here's an assignment, and let's say I'm a student. I'm gonna open this Oceans assignment, and in the upper right, there's a little Immersive Reader button. And when I click it, I get the full Immersive Reader for my instructions. So I'm gonna go here, click play.
Instructions. For this assignment, I'd like you to first go through the
So I get the full Immersive Reader right here in assignment. So I can change the background color, increase spacing, I can translate, picture dictionary, all of those things. I can go full screen as well right here in the upper right, right, for the assignment. So that's very inclusive.
That was a nice quick demo of how Immersive Reader works in assignments. All of those are built right into Teams today. And you can use them today in the web or the desktop or the Mac with the Immersive Reader aspects. We also have things like math in OneNote, which you can have built into Teams. All of Microsoft Word and PowerPoint, we have speech to text built into those apps. So you can use speech to text right inside of Teams with Word and PowerPoint and OneNote. And also things like accessibility checker in Word, accessibility checker in PowerPoint. The last one I'll show is translation of posts and chats.
Okay, we'll be showing how to translate a message in Teams. And just a note, your IT administrator has to enable this first. So I'm going to click on my photo up top, and I'm going to go to Settings. Now let's say I'm a student that speaks Spanish at home and primarily reads Spanish. I can scroll down here and change my language. Now I'll select Spanish. There we go, and now I save and restart. So now I'm back in, and I still have the message from my teacher here, but now I'm going to go to the dot, dot, dot menu, and I'm going to click on Translate here and watch what happens. That message is now translated into Spanish, so I can read this full message at home. This also works for chat. So if I go to chat in the upper left, here's a message right here in my chat window. I go to the dot, dot, dot menu, and I click Translate. And it translates that message right into Spanish. So really great for students that might not be able to read the native language quite as well. It can also be useful for their parents if their parents aren't engaging.
So that's a roundup of all the inclusive and accessible features in Teams. Also, though, I want to make sure you know about the great resources we have for educators, training and videos and tips and tricks. First off, I have a YouTube channel where I have an enormous number of inclusive and accessible quick tip videos for Teams, for accessibility features, inclusive reading and writing, math, and our inclusive communication. So check out that YouTube channel right here and subscribe to it. I also have a meetings quick tips playlist. So Teams meetings and many of those new features that are just starting to roll out, these are short and sweet 2-3-4 minute videos where you can learn exactly how to use these and then show them in your schools with your classrooms. And then I also have an inclusive classroom and accessibility quick tips playlist. And the links for these, the playlists are on the channel. The links are also in this deck, which is available at the end here. I'll have a QR code where you can get a copy of this deck if you'd like. We also have an incredible accessibility site. This site here is one of my favorite sites in the world. It's something that allows you to see the entire spectrum of Microsoft accessibility technologies. It's broken down into categories of like mobility, speech, executive functioning, reading, writing, and math, non-native speakers, all sorts of things. And you can go as deep or as broad as you want on this site. So I really encourage you, check this MEC accessibility site out and bookmark that one. And wrapping up, we have short and sweet interactive guides. So if you want an interactive click-through for our different categories of capabilities, these aren't necessarily Teams-specific, but they're Office 365-specific for inclusive reading, writing, math, and communication. Check out these guides. They're really, really great. You can share them with parents. You can share them with other administrators. You can try them out yourself. If you want a copy of today's presentation, here is the link right here. I also have a QR code. Reach out to me in email. I put my email address right here. Send me a mail, ask me questions, share feedback with me, and also follow me on Twitter. And I put out lots of tweets. Ask me on Twitter, tweet me some stuff. I'm pretty active on Twitter. So thank you very much, and I hope you have a great ISTE, and we'll see you.